So I hope the PPT is visible. So what all topics you have is the definition, general introduction of the intake structure. Then what are the factors governing the location? How do you find out in a river or in a canal what will be the appropriate place for an intake structure? And then there are different kinds of intake structure in your syllabus, that is simple submerged intake structure, intake towers, medium-sized river intake structure, canal intakes, and intakes for sluice ways of dams. Okay. So basically, what is an intake structure? The basic function of an intake structure is to help in safely withdrawing water from the source, and then to discharge this water into the withdrawal conduit. With conduit in the sense pipeline. Pipe ko hi dusra naam kya hai, to like technically usko conduit bolte, theek hai? And then discharging the water to the withdrawal conduit through which it reaches the treatment plant. Okay, it is constructed at the entrance of the withdrawal conduit. In the sense, the pipe jo hum bole na, maine bola na directly pipe hum kyun nahi laga sakte, to wo jo pipe hai, that is called the withdrawal conduit, jahan se pani withdraw hota hai. So it is constructed at the entrance of the withdrawal conduit and thereby protecting it from being damaged or clogged by ice or debris. Kuch type ka kachra jo bhi hai, wo pipeline mein nahi jana chahiye jo treatment plant ko connect hota hai. Theek hai? Sometimes from reservoirs where gravity flow is possible, water is directly transmitted to the treatment plant through intake structure. If gravity flow is not possible, water entering the intake structure is lifted by pumps and taken to the treatment plant. That is depending upon the location of the intake structure. Agar wo upstream pe hai, higher side pe hai, then obviously there koi pump lagane ka zarurat hi nahi hai intake structure mein. There is no requirement of the pump room. Okay, directly then water can pass through gravity. If at all, mostly the intake structure happens to be at the lower side. So obviously then we are supposed to provide the pump room or pump house in that intake structure, which will pump the water and pass it on to the water treatment plant. Okay. So basically, it is a small, simple type of submerged intake structure. That is how the intake structure looks like. See, if you could see here, this is a river side, okay, or a stream side. Then you have this concrete block wherein you have provided this withdrawal conduit or a pipeline. Okay, flexible joint. In the sense, to overcome the temperature stresses, the expansion and contraction of the pipelines, these joints are provided. And then you have, जहाँ से पानी pipeline में आ रहा है, there you have bar screens, so that the whatever type of large size floating particles or say some debris, okay, those are obstructed to flow through the pipe. So that is why the screening or bar screens are provided. So water after screening from this enters into this conduit and then passes through this jack well or sump well, it is called. Okay, this is constructed well. So it passed through this well. Again, here you can see a pipeline. It is called a suction pipe because it has a pump over this which sucks the water, okay, from this well. So here also you have a strainer. Strainer in the sense, it is same like your this screening process only, wherein again, if at all there are any particles, large size particles, they could be removed, and removed in the sense they could not enter into the suction pipe. Okay, so you provide this strainer. जैसे तुम्हारा छन्नी रहता है और चाय से तुम निकालने के लिए जो यूज करते हो. Okay, it's like that type of strainer. So you have a suction pipe and you have a pump from which this water collected in the well is collected and then pass it on to the treatment plant. So basically this whole structure is called the intake structure. Okay, so this was a simple type of the intake structure. Then how do you select the location of an intake structure? Kaisa hona chahiye location? The site should be near the treatment plant. One second. To reduce the conveyance cost. Obviously, the water is going to pass from the intake structure to the treatment plant. So, ऐसा नहीं ना intake structure कोई दूसरे corner में है और treatment plant कोई दूसरे corner में है. So, you require the water will flow from so long pipes to reach that treatment plant. So, basically, your site of the intake structure should be near to the treatment plant. Okay. The intake must be located in the purer zone of the source so that best quality of water is withdrawn from the source to reduce the load on the treatment plant. Okay. ऑब्वियसली जैसे मैंने तुमको पहले बोला था कि अगर कोई जगह पे सपोज सम इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट डिस्पोजल हो रहा है तो वहां पे तो मैं इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर नहीं लगाऊंगी, कंस्ट्रक्ट करूंगी, करेक्ट? या जहाँ पे नेविगेशन है, जहाँ पे शिप्स का मूवमेंट है, ओके, वहां पे भी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर नहीं, बिकॉज दैट वाटर इज डज नॉट कम अंडर द प्योरर जोन देन. ओके, सो योर साइट ऑफ द इंटेक स्ट्रक्चर शुड ऑल्सो बी लोकेटेड सो दैट द प्योरर जोन ऑफ द वाटर सोर्स इज सिलेक्टेड. ओके, the intake must be never be located in the vicinity of wastewater disposal unit. As I told you, obviously contaminated water you are not supposed to collect it, so it should not be in the vicinity of the wastewater disposal unit. Intake must never be located near the navigation channel so as to reduce the chances of pollution due to waste discharge from ships. Ye bhi maine tumko abhi bataya. Then the site should be such as to permit greater withdrawal of water if required in future. Okay, that is it should have like continuous availability of water us jagah pe hona chahiye, plus there should be sufficient scope for future addition and expansion. So your site should be at such a place. The intake must be located at a place from where it can draw water even the driest period of the year. I told you this. The intake site should remain easily accessible during the floods and should not get flooded. Okay, so it should not happen that the intake, the structure gets flooded due to the floods in that river. So you have to suppose your intake structure at such a place. Then in meandering, there is a moving rivers, the intake should not be located on the curves or at least on the sharp curves. Now what happens in the meandering rivers, if at all they are supposed to be constructed on the curves, it is better to locate the intake structures on the concave banks. The river move hota, it has a convex and the concave bank, right? So it would be preferable if the intake structure is actually situated on the concave side, because the water always remains available on that side, whereas the convex matlab bahar ka side bolte hai bank, okay, the water may not be remain available mostly because due to the silting side, silting bhi zyada hai and which might cause blockages also in the intake structure. So if at all you are supposed to provide the intake structures on the curves, preferably it should be provided on the concave side. Okay, then these are the different types of intake structures, as I told you previously also. That is simple submerged intakes, intake towers, medium sized river intake structures, canal intakes, intakes for sluice waste of the dam. Okay, so we'll move forward. So simple submerged intake structure, that is, it consists of a simple, jo humne pehle diagram mein maine tumko bataya tha na, this thing, this is your simple submerged intake structure, simplest one. That is, it consists of a simple concrete block or a rock filled timber creep. In the sense, see, ye diagram hai and ye diagram hai, these two are the submerged intake structures. To isme kya hai, एक तो या तो तुम्हारा जो पाइपलाइन है जहां से वाटर कलेक्ट हो रहा है, इट इज सपोर्टेड ऑन द कंक्रीट ब्लॉक, और जैसे वो उसमें लिखा था कि वुडन क्रीप, टिम्बर क्रीप, रॉक फिल टिम्बर क्रीप बताया था ना वर्ड, तो रॉक फिल टिम्बर क्रीप इन द सेंस दिस. फॉर एग्जांपल, क्रीप किसको बोलते हैं, टिम्बर क्रीप, आम का पेटी आता है, पेटी, ओके, वो जो वुडन का, दैट इज कॉल्ड द टिम्बर क्रीप, वुडन का होता है ना वो, ओके, दैट बॉक्स, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द टिम्बर क्रीप. ओके, सो दैट टिम्बर क्रीप इन विच द रॉक इज फिल्ड एंड फ्रॉम वेयर द वाटर एंटर्स इनटू द पाइपलाइन, दैट इज कॉल्ड द रॉक फिल्ड टिम्बर क्रीप. ओके, आई गो ऑन द फर्स्ट स्लाइड. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ सिंपल कॉन्क्रीट ब्लॉक और ए रॉक फिल्ड टिम्बर क्रीप Okay, rock fill timber crib supporting the start end of the withdrawal pipe. The intake opening is generally covered by the screen so as to prevent entry of debris, ice, etc. in the withdrawal country. ये तो तुमको मैंने पहले बताया. The screens are provided at the initial collection of the water. Then, in lakes where silt tends to settle down, intake opening is generally kept at about 2 to 2.5 meter above the lake bed level to avoid entry of the silt. Okay, so this is usually kept at such a height wherein the silting जहाँ पे होता है वहाँ पे entry ना हो water का. They are cheap and do not obstruct navigation, and they are widely used for small water supply projects, drawing water from streams or lakes, having a little change in the water level throughout the year. Limitation is that they are not easily accessible. Yeah, it is very difficult for cleaning and repairing in such type because they are submerged into the water, right? So cleaning becomes or repairing and maintenance becomes difficult. So this is a submerged type because the whole thing from where the water is collected is submerged inside the stream or the lake surface. Okay, so these are used for the small water supply projects, and that is why these are located on the stream or the lake sides. Okay, wherein you just have a pipeline which collects the water, which has a strainer or you can say a screening to avoid entry of the debris or any kind of waste, floating matter. Okay, and then this passes through the this well, which is also called as a jack well or the sump well, where again you have a suction pipe. Attached to the suction pipe is the strainer, and you have this pump, and then from this it is the water is sucked and then passed through the treatment plant. Similarly, this is also same, only the change is here. That was a pipeline supported on the concrete block, and this is a pipeline which is inside this rock fill timber crib. Okay, so you have a rock fill timber crib in which you have bar screens, and from which it enters here, goes through your withdrawal conduit or the pipeline, and the rest of the thing is same. Strainer, then the suction pipe, pumps, and to the treatment plant. Okay, so the rest of the things are same. So this is your simple submerged intake structure. उसके नाम में तुमको याद रखना है, ठीक है? Submerged है मतलब this from where the water is collected, the whole structure from where the water is collected is submerged inside the water source. Okay. Then you have intake towers. These are widely used on large water supply projects, drawing water from rivers or reservoirs, जहाँ पे water store होता है, ठीक है? Having large change in the water level. Okay, मतलब ये अब ये पहले वाला क्या था? Simple submerge. इसमें क्या था? It was on the small water supply projects on lakes and streams where water level changes जो है वो इतना नहीं होता था. ओके, थ्रू आउट द ईयर द वाटर लेवल चेंजेस वेर नॉट सो वैरिड, लेकिन ये जो इनटेक टॉवर्स है दिस आर प्रोवाइडेड फॉर लार्ज वाटर सप्लाई प्रोजेक्ट्स, फॉर रिवर्स और रिजर्वर्स, और जहाँ पे चेंज इन वाटर लेवल यूजुअली यू वुड सी. ओके, गेट कंट्रोल ओपनिंग्स कॉल्ड पोर्ट्स आर प्रोवाइडेड एट वेरियस लेवल्स इन दिस कॉन्क्रीट टॉवर टू रेगुलेट द फ्लो. मैं डायग्राम बताती हूँ तुमको, क्या लिखा था? गेट कंट्रोल ओपनिंग्स called as ports are provided. मतलब ये जो तुमको ये डायग्राम है एक इंटेक टॉवर का ही, इसमें देखो this part wherein the arrow is shown, okay, this inside one, okay, so these are called the gate control ports in the shaft लिखा है ना, okay, and this is the gate. अगर ये गेट पूरा आ जाता है यहाँ तक, मतलब ये पूरा जो है बंद है. अगर ये ऊपर तक है, मतलब इतना पार्ट में जो वाटर है दैट विल फ्लो थ्रू इट. अगर ये पूरा ओपन है, मतलब द होल वाटर फ्रॉम ऑल द दिस थिंग पोर्ट्स विल एंटर इनटू इट. सो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द वाटर लेवल ये जो गेट का ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग इज रेगुलेटेड. ओके, मतलब अगर तुम्हारा वाटर लेवल अगर in a sense itna half of the tower it is only, so it is better to keep open only this bottom port. Okay, so likewise, and this one port will be kept closed by the gates. So this is how the regulation of the opening and closing of the ports is done by the gate. Okay, so just to show it. Then gate control opening call ports are provided at various levels in these concrete towers to regulate the flow. If the entry ports are submerged at all the levels, there is no problem of any clogging or damage by ice or debris. Okay. Then there are two major types of intake towers, that is wet intake tower and dry intake tower. ये इंटेक टॉवर्स जो है, टॉवर्स नाम में इज द कॉन्क्रीट टॉवर, मतलब एक यू नो एलोंगेटेड और लॉन्ग साइज सम कॉन्क्रीट टॉवर इज मेड, सो इसके नाम में ही है, इट इज अ कॉन्क्रीट टॉवर. बस इसमें दो टाइप्स क्या है कि वेट इंटेक एंड ड्राई इंटेक. आई शो यू द डायग्राम फर्स्ट एंड देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन. अभी ये वेट इंटेक टॉवर देखो, ये ऐसा है. ओके, सो इसमें क्या है, यू कुड सी ये द रिजर्वॉयर लेवल. ओके, there is some intake tower created constructed concrete one. You have roof truss of course, and then you have this control mechanism and separation room, and you have this gates for controlling the opening and closing of the ports. Yahan pe kya hai, if you could see here outside also you have this openings, बट यहाँ पे रेगुलेट करने के लिए कोई गेट्स नहीं है. मतलब वाटर एट एनी लेवल विल ऑलवेज गेट इनसाइड दिस पर्टिकुलर एरिया. इतना पार्ट में वाटर हमेशा रहेगा क्योंकि यहाँ पे कोई गेट्स ही नहीं है, क्योंकि बाहर के साइड पे कोई गेट्स नहीं है उसका ओपनिंग और क्लोजिंग रेगुलेट करने के लिए. बराबर, सो दीज आर कॉल्ड द एंट्री पोर्ट्स, राइट, एंड दीज आर कॉल्ड द गेट कंट्रोल पोर्ट्स. ओके, एंट्री पोर्ट्स एंड गेट कंट्रोल पोर्ट्स. तो एंट्री पोर्ट्स में कोई ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन या कोई गेट नहीं है क्लोजिंग एंड ओपनिंग करने के लिए. बराबर, सो वाटर विल ऑलवेज गेट इनसाइड दिस. मतलब इतना जो पार्ट है, दिस विल ऑलवेज बी फिल्ड विद वाटर. इट्स ओनली द इनसाइड शाफ्ट विच इज कनेक्टेड टू द विड्रॉवल कंड्यूट. दिस विल डिपेंड अपॉन द एंट्री ऑफ दिस ऑपरेशन ऑफ दिस गेट्स. बराबर, तो मतलब ये जो शाफ्ट के बाहर का एरिया है, this will always be filled with water, and that is why it is called the wet intake towers. Matlab ye inside wala jo tower hai, it will always be filled with water from outside because water is coming from this entry port. So this is called the wet intake tower. Wahi agar dry intake ka main tumko picture dikhau, dry intake tower mein sirf kya difference hai, ye jo bahar ka part tha wet intake mein wo gayab ho gaya, वो है ही नहीं. इट्स ओनली द इनसाइड शाफ्ट कनेक्टिंग टू द विड्रॉवल कंड्यूट और उसको लगे हुए ये गेट्स. ओके, तो इसके बाहर का जो पार्ट था वेट इंटेक टॉवर में, एंट्री पोर्ट्स जहाँ पे थे, वो पार्ट ही गायब है. तो इसमें क्या होगा, इफ एट ऑल द गेट्स आर क्लोज कम्प्लीटली, मतलब दोनों भी ये जो पोर्ट्स है उसको बंद कर दिया, तो पानी इसके अंदर रहेगा ही नहीं. बराबर, इट विल बी एम्प्टी. ओके, in unless and until the gates are open, water cannot enter into it. So many if at all the gates are closed, this part will always remain dry. If at all the gates are the ports are closed by the gates, so this will not be filled with water. So that is why it is called the dry intake tower. Okay, so this is a basic difference between the wet intake tower and dry intake tower. Agar ek bhi diagram yaad reh gaya, matlab wet intake ka agar yaad reh gaya, to dry intake mein kya hai, sirf outside part nikal dene ka hai. Okay, because it is not filled with water every time. Okay, so your wet intake tower consists of a concrete circular shell filled with water up to the reservoir level. Okay, and has a vertical inside shaft which is connected to the withdrawal pipe. So this is your concrete shell outside, and this is your vertical shaft connected to the withdrawal pipe. Okay, the withdrawal pipe may lie over the bed of the rivers or may be in the form of tunnels below the river bed. Okay, so it could be through the river bed in the sense like tunnels, or it could be above the river bed. Okay, the pipeline above the river bed or through inside bolenge to like a tunnel. Openings are made in the outer concrete shell as well as on the inside shaft, right? Gates are usually placed on the shaft so as to control the flow of water to the shaft and the withdrawal conduit. Water coming out of the withdrawal pipe may be taken to the pump house for lifting if treatment plant is at higher elevation, और मे बी डायरेक्टली टेकन टू द ट्रीटमेंट प्लान इफ इट इज अ लोअर एलिवेशन. तो ये तो हमें पता है कि व्हेन डू यू रिक्वायर पंपिंग, राइट. सो दिस इज हाउ इट लुक्स, दैट इज वाटर अगर इसमें से विड्रॉल कंड्यूट से लेके जाके अगर डाउन स्ट्रीम में वाटर ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट है तो डायरेक्टली बाय ग्रेविटी इट कैन गो. अगर तुम्हारा वाटर ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट अपस्ट्रीम में है तो देन दिस वाटर हैज टू बी पंप्ड एंड देन पास टू द ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट. ओके, सो दिस इज हाउ योर वेट इंटेक टावर लुक्स लाइक, वेरिन यू हैव एन इन साइड वर्टिकल शाफ्ट which is connected to the withdrawal pipe. Outside the vertical shaft is completely covered with the concrete shell which is always filled with water because it does not have any gate control openings. Gate control openings are only there for the vertical shaft. Okay. Then dry intake tower, the water is directly drawn in the withdrawal conduit to the gate entry ports. It has no water inside the tower if the gates are closed, right? I told you that when the entry ports are closed, a dry intake tower will be subjected to additional buoyant force. ये तो बराबर है ना? अगर entry ports closed है और उसमें मतलब पानी नहीं है, तो obviously अगर वो खाली है, it's an empty structure, so it will have greater buoyant, it will be impacted by greater buoyant force. उतना heavier नहीं रहेगा वो, बराबर? If at all it is dry and empty. So hence it must be of heavier construction than the wet intake tower so as to overcome this buoyant force. They are useful since water can be withdrawn from any selected level of the reservoir by opening the port at that particular level. Okay, बराबर? मतलब इसमें फॉर एग्जाम्पल इसमें पाइपलाइन या ये शाफ्ट में पानी आने का है तो कौन से लेवल पे मैंने ओपनिंग रखने का, मैं बस एक जगह पे ओपनिंग रख के चलेगा क्या? तो यू नो यहाँ पे दो दिखाया है, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द डेप्थ यू कैन प्रोवाइड डिफरेंट ओपनिंग्स एट डिफरेंट इंटरवल्स एंड देन डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द वाटर लेवल दैट ओपनिंग कुड बी ओपन बाय दिस गेट्स. Okay, so it has it is useful to collect water from any level of the water. Okay, so this is your dry intake tower wherein you do not have any concrete shell outside, you just have this vertical shaft with the gate operated ports. Okay, then after this intake tower, pehla kya tha? Submerged intake tha. Next was the intake tower which had dry and wet intake. The next is the medium size river intake structures. Okay, so they are generally constructed for withdrawing water from almost all the river. They are classified as twin well type of intake structure and single well type of intake structure. अभी भी इसके नाम में ही है, twin well मतलब दो well तो होने वाले हैं, and when you call as दो well in the sense artificially created well, in the sense it's not the well you see in the village, it's like the concrete tower or structure created to collect the water. Okay, so you have twin well type of river intake structure and you have single well type of river intake structure. So when you talk about twin well type of intake, again I'll show you the diagram first and then we'll move to the description. Twin well type of intake structure, मतलब इसमें दो well होने ही चाहिए. पहले इसके लाइन में क्या लिखा है? They are constructed on almost all types of rivers where river water hugs the river bank. A typical river intake structure consists of three components: inlet well, inlet pipe, or which is also called as intake pipe, and jack well. So you have inlet well, which is also called as the intake chamber. Okay, one well, then you have withdrawal conduit or you can say inlet pipe, and then you have this different well which is also called as the sump well or the jack well. Okay, intake chamber or intake well, then you have withdrawal conduit or the inlet pipe, and then you have this sump well or the jack well. So this is your construction of the twin well type of intake structure. Okay, inlet well is usually circular in cross section and made of masonry or concrete. Inlet pipe connects inlet well with the jack well. It has minimum diameter of 45 cm. We are talking about this inlet pipe. Okay, this particular pipe connecting the intake well to the jack well. Okay. So it has a minimum diameter of 45 centimeter, laid at a slope of 1 in 200, and flow velocity through it is less than 1.2 meter per second. Water entering the jack well is lifted by pumps and fed into the rising main, that is the main pipeline. Jack well should be founded on hard strata having bearing capacity of the soil more than 450 kilonewton per meter square. Okay. Because it is the final thing that is going to collect the water. Okay. So it has to be constructed on a hard strata. That is hard strata in essence, with the soil having good safe bearing capacity. Okay. So that is why, so that is how it looks. That is, you have this intake chamber or the intake well, wherein you have gate entry ports only, and you have screening provided at the entry. So water can pass through this, and then it is connected here, from where you again have fine screening. You can see this line. Okay, so that is fine screening. ये तो bar screening जो coarse screening भी बोलते हैं उससे ज़्यादा fine अगर screening करते हैं उसे, और the openings are very minute, so it has to remove even the fine particles. So this you provide as fine screening, and फिर वो fine screening से it goes to your withdrawal conduit, and then from the withdrawal conduit again the same thing which we have seen in the other intake structures also, that you have a strainer, then you have a suction pipe, you have a pump room, and from there it is passed to the treatment plant. Okay. And plus you could see this dotted line जो है original ground line, उसको ही cut करके जो है you have constructed this thing, you have also this footbridge also. Okay, so this is all the constructed part, and this was the previous original ground line. Okay, then single well type क्या है, I'll show you the diagram. See, again twin well में दो well थे, single well में you have one well only. Okay. Very you know, very easy diagram. You just have a particular well which is also called as a sump well or jack well. जैसे तुमको बताया था कि इसमें जो है single well में ये वाला चीज गायब ही है, this part and this part गायब हो गया, सिर्फ इतना ही part है. So you have a single well which is called the sump well. Then you have the different ports here. You have different ports from where water could be collected, but यहाँ पे तुम देखो gate controlled ports नहीं है. Depending upon the water level, they can enter into the this thing, the structure. Okay, and then you have this some strainer, and then again same thing, the pump and the suction pipe, and from there it is passed on. Okay, so it is a very simple type, single well type of intake structure. No inlet well or inlet pipe in this type of river intake structure is provided. Opening or ports fitted with the bar screen are provided in the jack well itself. मैंने जैसे बोला इसको sump well भी बोलते हैं और jack well भी बोलते हैं. In other diagrams you could not see openings like this in the jack well or the sump well, but in the single well type of intake structure where there is no inlet pipe also, where there is no other well also like inlet well or intake well. So directly the openings are provided at the on the jack well or the sump well itself. Okay, so openings or ports are fitted with bar screens and are provided with the jack well itself. The sediment entering will usually be less since clearer water will enter the offtake channel. Okay, so that is offtake channel in the sense, if at all a particular river has a diversion to a particular different channel. Okay, और वहाँ पे अगर ये बनाते हैं intake structure, तो most of the times the water received is free of sediments, because sediments mostly get deposited on the river sides. The silt entering the jack well will partly settle down in the bottom silt zone of the jack well, or may be lifted with the pumped water, since pumps can easily lift the sedimented water. The jack well can be periodically cleaned manually or by stopping the water entry into the well. Okay. Then, after this well type of intake structure, one second. Then you have kernel index, which in the name itself says whenever such an index structure is to be constructed on the kernels, then it is called the kernel index structure. So see the diagram how it looks. In case of the kernels, the intake well is located on the bank of the kernel, as you can see, right? And the water enters the chamber through an inlet pipe. Okay, in the sense, this water entering into the the water is entering from this particular entry and through this withdrawal conduit, okay, to this sump well or directly to a not city here. Why it is showing me a city? Like it aisa hota hi nahi hai ki water treatment plant nahi ho. So actually the city is direct, unhone destination bata diya ki kahan pe wo jata hai. The middle treatment plant they haven't shown here. Okay, so basically or city likho hi mat wahan pe. Actually they are showing you ki you know the first and the last destination, like they are showing ki intake structure se directly city tak beech mein ka treatment plant unhone gaya bhi kar diya. So so what in the canal is the flow area in the canal, like you could see here, the port is provided and wherein the core screening, fine screening, depending upon the size of the openings that the screens are providing. Okay, core screening matlab larger size particles or sediments could be obstructed in getting into the water. Fine screening matlab there are finer openings, so kam size wale bhi jitna bhi debris or waste hai ya jo bhi hai floating matter, that could be avoided. Okay, so here also what they have shown ki in the canal intake structure you have the entry through the core screen and then it goes to your it gets collected into this particular well, and from where again you have a this is called the intake well. Okay, and then it is from where, from the fine screening provided at the withdrawal conduit, then it is passed through it to a particular if at all required a sump well or else directly to a treatment plant. Okay, so in this you have just the intake well and intake pipe bolenge ya withdrawal pipe bolenge jo bahar pani leke ja raha hai, theek hai. And then you have a wall operating mechanism yahan pe jo dikhaya hai inme for entry of the water. Okay, so for entry and closing of the water, that is regulation of the water, you provide a wall inside this withdrawal conduit. Okay, so this is how it looks. Yahan pe inhone dikhaya hai for connecting your canal. Yahan pe dekho, it is not connected to your whole side of the canal, so for connecting it you have provided footbridge connection. Okay, so this is how your canal intake, simple, almost all the intake structure looks similar only. Okay, matlab component parts to uske same hi hote, mostly same hi hote ki entry port, then this withdrawal conduit, this wells. Okay, these are already there. Then you have intakes for sluice ways of the dam. Sluice ways of the dam, in the sense tumne dam ka structure dekha rahega. Okay, so jahan pe you have this slanting slide, jahan pe isko toe bolte hain hum. Okay, yahan pe jo slanting slide hai wahan pe you provide the intakes which is called the intake sluice ways of dam. Now isme kya hai, isme bhi do part hai. It depends upon the type of dam also. Okay, so that is, if at all you are providing it for an earthen dam, it is situated on the upstream of the toe of the earthen dam. Okay, and if at all it is to be provided for the gravity and masonry, so this is how the intake structure is provided, mostly inside part. Okay, so iska zyada tumko hai nahi, main batati hu, lekin sirf diagram se now you could find out. Actually if at all you are you know, अगर तुमको डायग्राम भी याद है तो यू कैन इजीली दिस थिंग डिस्क्राइब अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर वर्किंग ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर, क्योंकि वर्किंग सबका सेम ही है. सी इफ यू कुड सी हियर अर्थन डैम, दिस लुइस वे, दैट इज द स्लैंटिंग पार्ट एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड द टो पार्ट. ठीक है, तो इसको यहाँ पे ऐसा प्रोवाइड करते हैं ऑन द अपस्ट्रीम ऑफ द टो एंड यू कुड सी योर फुट ब्रिज कनेक्टेड. नो ये ना तुम लोग कहीं पे अगर डैम विजिट करने जाओगे तो यू कुड सी दिस टाइप ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर वेर इन वी गेट कंफ्यूज वेदर इट इज फॉर जनरेशन. कभी कभी वहां पे जनरेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी के लिए भी स्ट्रक्चर वो लोग बनाते ना, तो यू माइट गेट कंफ्यूज विद दैट. यू माइट गेट कंफ्यूज विद द पंप हाउस. ओके कंट्रोल रूम है, पंपिंग अगर है, पंप वहां पे दिखे तो यू गेट कंफ्यूज विद लाइक अ पंप हाउस इट इज, ऐसा भी. So most of the times you could see this type if you visit the dam, wherein you have this particular structure created, जहाँ पे you could see these pipelines, intake pipes, sorry intake conduits जो बोला है, conduits are nothing but pipes. So these pipes are provided at different water levels in the dam. Okay, for different water levels they are provided. और हर एक को जो है, there is valves provided, which are also called as the intake valves for entry and exit of the water. जैसे पहले इसमें गेट था ना, तो इसमें इट इज द वॉल्व्स दैट आर प्रोवाइडेड फॉर द एंट्री एंड एग्जिट ऑफ द वाटर. ठीक है, एंड एवरी इनटेक पाइपलाइन इज कवर्ड विद दिस स्क्रीन्स और स्ट्रेनर, सो दैट द वाटर ऑफ गुड क्वालिटी दैट इज एक्सेप्ट द फ्लोटिंग मैटर गेट्स इनटू इट. ओके, एंड देन दिस वाटर देन पासिस थ्रू दिस विड्रॉवल कंड्यूट. ओके, so and this also this is also called the intake well, the intake well you want, okay, or intake tower. ठीक है, so intake well ये भी अगर होता है डैम में, mostly concrete डैम में, masonry डैम में, you could see this type of intake structure wherein same structure है, सिर्फ उसका जो positioning है वो अलग है. ठीक है, same you have this intake well or tower and the intake pipeline at different levels of the water. So this was all about your intake structure. Depending upon wherein you are going to provide this intake structure, depending upon how there are changes in the water level, the different type of intake structures are provided. Okay, or obviously the cost, then the amount of water to be collected, quality of the material, all those are the other factors which affect the type of intake structure to be created in a particular area. Okay,